The rescuers busted in the window, and a figure emerged from the attic, a teenage girl who didn't know how to swim.
I'm holding on to this.
No, let go of that and put your arms on that life preserve.
How deep is that water right there?
The cops tossed her a life vest.
You don't put it on, just hold it on your chin, like this. Yeah, hold it like that.
And eventually got her to the boat.
What was going through your mind here?
I just thought I was gonna die. Because the water came in so fast, so I thought I was gonna die real quickly.
The officer who led the rescue, NOPD Sergeant Danny Scanlon, recounts that moment when all of the rest of the chaos would have to wait. And all his focus,
come on! There you go.
Was directed to one teenage girl.
I remember she was extremely scared. She got on there and she kind of dog paddled over, and she got out the water and got into the boat.
Thank you.
All right.
She was like so many other teens. And within minutes, this teenager, her 85-year-old grandmother, her mother and uncle were on their way to safety. Today, Courtney is known to her colleagues and to her patients as Dr. Jackson. She lives in D.C. and has a practice in Maryland, a dream come true.
I couldn't let Katrina or anything else like deter me from my dreams because I'm very determined and motivated. And my mom even told me when I graduated dental school, she was like, I'm so proud of you. She said that she was just so proud of me that she knew that I would be successful. So. You know, to hear that from my mom is just so, it's amazing because you just never know if you're doing the right thing, and for someone to tell you that you're doing good, it's just a good, it's a good feeling, yeah.
Katrina couldn't drown any of your dreams?
No, it couldn't, nope. And any other dreams that I have, like, it can't, nope.